Hey there. This is Giga Wrecker, made by Game Freak. Yeah, I didn't know they did anything outside of Pokemon either. So I figured I'd try it out to see if I could catch a Charizard or something. March 20th, 2032. Those things suddenly appeared. Unidentified killing machines. Where they came from, how they got here. I don't know why I see a bunch of A, B's, and C's on the bottom of it in very faded text. Everyone came up with their own ideas, delusions, and theories. Secret weapons of some country went out of control. Maybe they're drones sent by aliens from outer space. They must be metallic life forms from another dimension. Artifacts from some ancient civilization. Conspiracy theories were even headlined on TV and newspapers. But all those only lasted for a few days. As their invasion advanced much faster than we could think, and cities disappeared one after another from our maps, nobody was making stupid rumors anymore. Our armies didn't have the chance against their unknown technologies. All they could do was fall back and retreat. 3 years have passed since then. Those who are left are barely living in this hell on Earth, and hiding inside ruins, crawling around like rats. If they find us, the old and sick will be killed. The young will be made slaves and worked to death. My family and friends, they all died. There's nothing happy about living in this world, but I never thought of dying. Giving in to all the unfairness, admitting our defeat, that's way more horrible than death. So even at the time they caught me, I waited for the chance to escape and tried to run away. I tried, but the next moment, I had a blade stuck through my body. Well, well, what a spectacle. Your left arm is gone from the shoulder, and your ribs have punctured through your heart. Your life will end in about 5 minutes, I guess. But I have the ability to save you. So, how about it? As I was fading away, I agreed with his offer. This man, Dr. Kozuki. I became the guinea pig for his studies, in exchange for bringing me back to life. Kozuki's a mad scientist. I had no other choice but to rely on him. What I got in trade for my pride was his crooked body, patched up on every side. Armed with his metal arm of a demon, I became a cyborg, half machine, half human. My name is Raika Raikeji. I probably messed that up. Hey. Hello there. Are you listening, girl? What's up? Having a dream? No. Just forget it. Well, looks like your communication functions are working fine. Okay, let's make things clear. What you want from me, and what I want from you. I want you to collect and send me as much experiment data as you can. You want me to get you out of this hellhole as soon as possible. That's right. I want to spend my new life out of here. So listen up. I got a plan that'll satisfy both you and me. You will search around this industrial area to collect and send me all the data. As soon as I'm happy with it, I'll tell you how to get out of here. The way out of here. Why do you know that? Don't forget, I'm a genius. Not only I saved you from your death, but I also turned you into the strongest cyborg. Who wouldn't call me a genius? For 3 years, day and night, I've devoted myself to those robotic research. The English is a little bit borky, but it's not that bad. Don't you think this is the ultimate source of information? A genius. Sure, I guess. They do say there's a fine line between genius and insanity. Besides, I don't have any other choice. Okay, I'm in. Yes, that's a good girl. So, let's get started. Okay. Oh my. Okay, I move really fast. I guess I gotta go up there and I could go this way. There is things over here. Jump, okay. Well, if that's the case, I want to go back then. I seem to lose momentum when I jump. That's okay. Oh, Wait, what a big landslide. I don't think I'll be able to climb over this. If only there were a way to get back to how was it was collapsed before. Okay. Oh, yep, I just got jumped so far. Don't worry, we can do this even if we don't have the momentum. We are a cyborg. Well, I mean, as of right now, the art's pretty solid. It definitely reminds me of the old Pokeverse. Can't I go up anymore? What's wrong? Ah, see those thin planks? You can climb down them. I know that, of course. Okay. We're a platformer. You did it. Speedrun tactics. No, those aren't. But we're doing okay. A wall. Am I already at a dead end? Of course not. No need to worry. Now is a good time. Let me introduce you to your new powers. The magnificent ultimate invention of all time. One beyond human, the power of the cyborg. Magnificent? I don't think that's the word to describe all this mess you've done to my body. Hey, don't accuse me, girl. You gave me permission. Well, you might not remember, though, because you were that close to death at the point. Of course. Let's go back to the subject about your new powers. It creates an electro wave from your amplified brainwaves and bioelectricity, which excites the nanomachines. Of course there's nanomachines. It's always nanomachines. And by adding moment to assembled crystals, this and this blah blah blah. Oh. So if I summarize it all, it means you can just bash through those walls. Got it. Not really sure how it all works, but it'll do. Okay. Physics. You see, as soon as physics get involved, I'm interested. I can break things, it's like I'm playing Revengeance. Except the camera work is a little bit better this time. Do it again. Okay. Easy peasy. Oh yeah, I could just do it up here. There you go. And then there's like things in this. I guess I want to collect those. I'm breaking a whole lot of shit. This is pretty neat so far. Bloodstill Arsenal Labor Slogan. Shining crystal, light of firmness, effort, energism, and self-progress. Okay. Oh, this just leaves me. I'm silly. There you go. Shiny blue things are flying towards me sometimes. Me too. What are these? Those are nanocrystals. It's the inner and dormant form of the nanomachines. They're one of the materials which form your new body. So if you collect them, I can use them to upgrade your cyborg abilities. Designed to fight and secure resources simultaneously. No one else can make such a masterpiece like this, if I do say so myself. I guess it won't hurt to collect them. True. All you gotta do is just hit things and run. It's easy peasy. Looks like a door, but I don't think I can go through it. Somewhere in the area, there should be some kind of control device. That'll unlock those kind of doors. Come on and go find it. Okay. I got you, Doc. Don't worry. I have ultimate faith in you, and you mean super well for my well-being. Yeah, that's it. Use that machine to unlock the door. I did it, Doc. I hope you're proud of me. I'm the best creation you've ever had. The best, the greatest. That's proper. Something's glowing there. That is a safe point. It keeps memories by transforming to quantum bit data. And so blah blah blah. Yeah, whatever. A save point, huh? I can guess what to do by the name of it. You never know what'll happen these days, so keep your records anytime you have the chance. Okay. Yes. That was loud. Alright. I gotta make sure I break in a way that doesn't put me in an advantage of not being able to get all the super cool shit. That's a very important thing. Okay. Getting used to this. I think I control the direction of my attacks. Hold on. Ah, I see. All right, fair enough. Oh, there's also like, if I do like over here and then I move over to the left while I'm doing it, so it'll let it come back down to me and also break them there too. Yep, like that. I'm a magician. You know what? This is nice. This is a nice feel so far. It's good groundwork. Because it's still an early access game. But I mean, it's pretty solid. I've played a lot worse when it comes to early access. Also, physics and stuff from my weak spot. You know, I got a, like a little tinkle good feeling when it comes to this kind of shit. So it works for me. Maybe I have a biased opinion right now. Maybe I played a lot of Pokemon back in the day. Maybe I got faith. I don't know. I just wanted to play video games today. I don't want to get on a whole soapbox. I need to do something with you. But I don't know what. Help me, Doctor. When you break walls and pillars, they become heaps of debris, right? You can jump on them as footing. So make use of them to explore this place. Sometimes destruction shall create new paths. Sounds like a wise saying, doesn't it? Break and create footing, right? But what happens if I do too much and destroy stuff which I shouldn't have? That's where you should use the singularity point. A singularity point? What's that? See the spot with the pink particles floating from the ground? That's the singularity point. It's where the tachyon exists and warps time and space. By interfering with the tachyon field, with the electrowave stimulation ability, you can use a tachyon burst which will rewind time. Rewind time, you make it sound so simple. Oh, it is. It is. Fuck. Oh no. I ruined it. Time is ruined. Holy shit, that's loud again. Do it again. Oh no. I ruined it. It's all over. Ow! Okay, try that again. There you go. Well done. Easy peasy. Caution. There have been reports of tachyon particles generated in the area. Due to the particles being unstable, unnecessary use of electric devices are prohibited. So you're saying I should do this? I agree. I should. Alright. A little bit wonky when it comes to collision with the things, but I'm sure it'll get better. Nice. Okay. I'm gonna get that research data for you, Doc. I'm sure you want it real bad. Okay. Don't worry. What's up with that wall? There's some kind of yellow stain on it. Those are nanomachines in liquid form. If you recall them, you can collect objects stained with them. Recall. You can draw nanomachines along with the debris by controlling them with electro waves. You can't pick up stuff too big, so crush them into pieces before doing it. Oh. Whoa. Oh. Oh, I have a giant ball of shit! With the nanomachine's crystallization effect, you can keep and use the recalled debris as a single mass. The more you collect, the bigger it will grow. Ah! Holy shit! More! Nice. Alright, this shit's like some motherfucking Katamari, mother goddamn motherfucking shitballs. Alright, you got me. I'm in. Bring me on this wild goose run. That's not even a term. People don't say that. Oh no, I want that. No, 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 come down here. Yeah, that's right. There we go. Absolutely worth it. My ball's getting a little tiny here. Hang on. There's a piece. Thank you. It got bigger just from that one piece. I'm not even talking about animes right now, even though it's pretty anime looking at this point in time. Damn it, I missed out on that one. That's okay. Get back here. Good deal. Okay. See, I don't know if I'm like, I'm missing some because I feel like this should be a larger mass at this point, but it's okay. Never seen this before. A transport device used, wait. A transport device using liquid nanomachine, just like an elevator. It reacts with the radio wave of recall. It lifts up the platform by spouting nanomachine. Activate it by jumping on and off you go flying. Even heavy girls like you. Wait a minute. I don't weigh that much, do I? The metal alloy that forms your new arms and bones, they're much heavier than you think. I see. Man, now you're gonna feel self-conscious if you ever gotta get weighed at a grocery store and everyone's looking at you. A grocery store. I went to one grocery store when I was a kid and they had a scale that people used. That's the only context I have for that exact situation. There's other instances where that would be better used. Not a grocery store. Blood Steel Arsenal Labor slogan. When carrying objects with nanomachine lift, always be alert. Look to your left and your right. Check everything around in sight. Okay. Well, I gotta check everything around in sight. Gotcha. Thank you. So how many things do I need to get the cool shit? I would definitely like the cool shit. And this is one big mass. Hey Doc. What's up, girl? I can grow my debris bile by recalling. I understand that, but what's the point of doing that? There are mainly two advantages. The first one increases your attack range. The bigger you grow your debris ball, the further you can reach with your debris attack. The second, you should find out soon. Find out soon. Alrighty then. Okay, Doc. Thanks for your cryptic mumbo jumbo. I appreciate it. You're the best, Doc. There you go. Now, my problem here is I don't know. Actually, no. I think we're fine here. Yeah. Yeah, we just gotta jump there, and then bam. We can make it. Good job. Now you see, he said it cryptically, he's like, you should find out soon. So you're probably going to be battling something soon. So if that is the case, you better be ready to win. If you don't win, I'm gonna be mad. Because you're gonna make me look bad. And I don't wanna look bad. I'm a robot girl and shit. That's something I dreamed of being ever since I was a little boy. I just wanted to be a robot girl. I watched a lot of weird shit when I was a boy. Aw, I lost my ball. Okay. Sure. God, you're loud. Okay. Wait, that's a class Raga. They seem to be labor robots, but are still deadly against humans. How could I forget? They slaughtered so many of us. Even my friends. Humans are powerless against them, but you are cyborg. You have the power to beat them. So just finish the job and go get me some combat data. You're right. They're no match for me. I can feel it. I have the power to prove it. The power to fight against all this unfair violence. I'm thankful for what you gave me this ability. Let me try that again. I'm thankful that you gave me this ability. Well, just a little. But keep in mind, being a cyborg means strong, not invincible. Alright. Anime time. Go! Whew! Alright! You might already know this, but you can recall and collect those robots' corpses after destroying them. That's because nanomachines flow through their body, just like blood inside a human. Ah, so I can use my enemy to my advantage. Nice. Alright, I'm gonna have a huge mass of fun. Good deal. Oh, hey. That. Oh, they goop the things. Alright, that's kinda neat. I've found a mechanic. Make them goop the walls and then I use the walls to get more. Goop the wall, thank you. There you go. I'm coming up. Hold on. I know you missed. Hey, nice attack. Good work. You won't do that again. I told you you wouldn't do that again because I killed you. Alright, that was pretty good. Oh, is there... Okay, I thought I reached my pinnacle point here. Official discipline. Damage and disposal caused from accidents during work is increasing. Accidents during work are unavoidable, but please be careful of damage to your bodies. This is for your own safety. But there are also reports that cleaning of spilt nanomachines on floor in facilities are an extreme hassle. Astravenata, Viceroy of Samsara. What did I just say? I don't know. I am God. Nice. Alright, so this ball is absolutely like 4 times my size right now. I'm in. I went the right way the first time. Someone get me a goddamn Olympic medal. I deserve it. I deserve this. Wish I could bring the ball with me though. That's a class Padma. Those things have a shield part, which makes things a little difficult. The shield part. The red and round thing on their head. It's a special structure that absorbs... Wow, I had a brain fart there. That absorbs damage. What do you mean? You're saying it's invincible? Calm down and listen. There are limits with their durability. If you hit them with a debris ball larger than the size of their shield part, you can destroy it, leaving them vulnerable. This is another advantage for keeping a larger debris ball. Alright. Hit it with a bigger debris ball. Simple enough. Okay then. I'm gonna teach you crude AIs a new program from now. The humiliation of defeat. And the fear of death. Oh man, you're getting all intense. Excuse me. Oh, you nice hit. You might have already noticed, but I made some enhancements with your eyes. You can now see if your debris attacks is stronger than your enemy's shield or not, by the color of the aura glowing on it. If the enemy's shield part is glowing red, your attacks won't work. If it's glowing blue, you can destroy it. I understand that it's more convenient, but what are you doing to my body? Stuff. Hey-ya! Yay! Yay! Oh shit, you're still alive. Hey. Nice, good fight, good fight. Alrighty. And this mass of dead alien bodies. It's a good time all around. Aw, that's so cute. You knocked the little head off and then it's like, aw. They're not used to this shit. I feel mean. This is a mean thing I'm doing right now. How could I be so cruel? You know, I really hope they actually like work on this and get it like nice and polished and shit. I'm digging this so far. This is a really cool premise. All the goop and physics and shit. It appeals to the inner child in me. Well done, Game Freak. You did it again. You appealed to the children. And the 90s kids that are now adults. How'd you do it? I don't know. It's very impressive. You have a gift. I need to go get a thing for you. This is a huge fucking ball. Excuse me. Thank you. Alright, now the one thing I'm missing so far, and I really hope there is it, is some super neat boss fights. If there's no super neat boss fights, then I'm gonna be a little upset. Please be a super neat boss fight in this. I'd really appreciate it. I'm gonna hit it and it's gonna be loud. I was right. Super neat boss fight? Oh, you look neat though. Jesus. Wait, you seriously think I can go against them? I've seen those before. They were ripping cars in half. The class Chakram. Indeed, they have a bigger shield part, which means stronger defense and nastier attacks. But you still have a chance of beating them. Match the timing of your debris attack and their tail swing, so you can break it off and use it to increase the size of your debris ball. Believe in your powers. What should I say? Believe in the technology and the theory of the genius who modified your body. You get on my nerves. But you're right. We came this far. There's no turning back now. Okay, let's do that. Now, it's their turn to be ripped apart. Alright, you. With your tail attack. Okay, that's how that... I did it. I need another one. Oh. Do I... Oh. Hiya! 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 I did it. Alright, so it wasn't a super cool boss fight, but we're getting there. We're getting to a bit more challenge. Sorry, little buddy. Jesus Christ. Alright, come on, Goop Ball. I'm sorry, Debris Ball. I should probably refer to you as you wish to be referred to. I'd be really fucked up if I didn't. Oh, yo, look at all this goop here. I'm in. Give me this shit. Aw, can't reach that one. Excuse me. Hold on. I don't want to miss any bit of a fun. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Excuse me. I don't mean to do that again. There. There we go. Hey, pal. Good fight. You were a very strong opponent. You too, my man. So, this giant mass definitely is... Like, I've already said it before. But this definitely gives me the Katamari Damacy vibe. And I don't got the music yet, but maybe they'll put in some. That'd be sweet. Oh, another one? Excuse me. Oh, Jesus. That wasn't supposed to happen. There you go. Lifts and labor robots. Let me guess, this place is some kind of factory or storage facility. If so, is there something wrong? About your nanomachine ability. It has a function you can use. Another one. Another function. Arms creating and handling effect. Call it Archie. I'm probably Archer, Parker, whatever. It's the ability to create weapons and gadgets by decomposing and reconstructing nanomachines and fragments. This function should help you out with fighting those robots. And even getting you out of here. Well, why can't I use them right now? There are some limits for creating and using Archie. One must know the complete structure to create it and use a weapon. What? I'd never learned about making weapons. No worries. You're gonna learn them right now. If this place is a factory or a depository, there must be some blueprint datas for weapons. Look for a data terminal with these information and just install them directly into your brain. Install what? Into my brain? Directly? Aw, no, it's cool, you're a robot. I'm sorry, a cyborg. It's gonna be fine. I knocked it. Hey, man, I need you. Give me this. Thank you. Alright, let's see here. There we go. Thank you. Done and done. I need this too. Thanks. I could have probably used your little goop there, but it's okay. I got what I needed. And that's all I needed. Oh, I just realized. Are my legs all robot too? I can't really tell because it's kind of zoomed away. Is there like a way I could... Wait, skill tree? Holy shit, there's a skill tree. Oh. It's pretty large too. Wait, I have skill points too. I can use these? Oh my god, I can use these right now. Oh shit. Increases your max. Sure. I want more vitality. And then, what do these do? These seem good. Increases the range of debris attack by holding down the shore. Thanks. And then this one, collect nanocrystals from terrain and enemies and use them as skill points. Sure. Huh. I didn't even realize that. Anything else then hidden in here? I could retire. I mean, I'm not old enough for that, I'd say, and I don't have enough savings, but that maybe one day in the future I'll hit that button. A navigation map? Oh, that's adorable. That is just precious. Look at this shit. That is... Okay. Alright. That's cute. You're cute. I like it so far. Looks like there's blueprint data inside that console. Check it out, girl. Alright. Installing ability program debris blade. Wow. Oh yeah, look at your legs. Those are neat. Looks like you got a weapon data. Alright, What is this? My head is spinning. By applying an Arki protocol to the nanomachines, you now have the ability to create the blade. The blade? The ability to form your debris into a sharp sword. You can slice straight through walls and pillars. Oh! Well, I'm sold. I need to find something to slice through today. Holy shit! No! I was sold and then you get a refund! Fuck! Holy shit. My controller's constantly vibrating. That was so weird. Oh, why are you still vibrating? What the fuck? Why? It's constantly vibrating. That is so weird. The game is closed, but my controller is constantly vibrating still, and I don't know why. I'm very confused. I'm actually kind of scared. I'm going to open up the game and hope it's okay. You're going to be okay. It's still vibrating. Oh no. Oh no. Can you stop vibrating? Is there a vibration? Off. Apply. It's still vibrating. You done? Nope. Alright, I'll just play it while it's constantly vibrating. Sure. Why not? I'll just play a vibrated playthrough. I'm sure that's gonna be in the future one day. There's people gonna do vibration runs. I hurt myself. Jesus, alright. Time to get back to- Aww, shit. Okay. I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna slash something and it's not gonna break it. Ah. Okay. It's kinda cool. I can't throw my ball anymore. I wonder if that's intended. Probably is. I think. Am I good now? Wait, where am I? Did I come downstairs? I think I did. Ah, I see. Alright, can I throw my ball still? Nope! I got no more ball throwing. Gotcha. Huh. Well, oh, now I can throw my ball. Alright, it just really wanted me to try it out. Gotcha. I understand what's happening. I didn't mean to do that. I wanted to slash him. I'm cool now. Okay. So, who needs real swords when you have fake swords or junk swords? Hey, yeah. Do you do? Good. Good, good, good. Alright. The physics are happening pretty well now when you got swords and. Aww. When you got swords involved, they're doing okay. They're doing okay. I guess I'm just gonna keep making a bunch of little bridges. I'm sorry. More like stairs. You're gonna get it. There you go. Nice. Okay. I want to go to the left. Because if I go to the right, then I only get to hit that guy. And that's just silly. Excuse me, fella. No. Okay. There. Good. And now I can go up here. And I'm gonna grab this. And I got that. And I hope to God I don't have to deal with another situation like that again. And I would be very grateful. Okay. Give me the goods. Okay, that was fucked up. Thank you. So. Okay. Now they're just starting to do a lot better than I was before. Because I'm on tilt. They got me on tilt. Listen, girl. When you're cutting pillars, it's important where to cut. That way it falls down. Though the way it falls down will change a lot. You can use your Archie in midair as well. So try it from different heights and positions. Okay. Okay. So I see what you're getting at here. I saw it and I did it. What the hell just happened? It's like I just dropped some of that off. I can't. They really don't want me to throw it around anymore. I wanted this, but I guess I don't get it anymore. And I just lost it. It's taking some goop from me. Wow. That's some messed up shit. Holy shit, a save point. Okay, now if it does another crash, it ain't so bad. But I hope it doesn't do another crash, because that shit gets me on tilt pretty bad. Not gonna lie. Early access games, man, that's how they do it. I did it. That was simple peasy peasy. Okay. No. You gotta do this. You gotta do this. There you go. Nice. Okay, now where is a boss? It's been a minute. It's been a long minute and I want a boss. Upgrading your Archie abilities, we made some progress here. They're quite different from my debris attack. So it might be quite useful. There are still more weapon data around. If you download more and use more Archie abilities, it's definitely not Archie. There's no way they call it Archie. I'm sure it will help you on your journey. Okay, thanks, Doc. Another save point. Okay. Sure. Wait, what the? Already? Wait, I don't go through there yet. Oh, I'm being stupid. I forgot I could just do it without anything. I'm already that. Okay, that's okay. But, hold on. Do I really go through? Weird. I guess I do. Ouch. Ouch. I got hit by both of those attacks because I was too impatient. There's the data console. Go and download it. Yeah, I know. Debris lock. Looks like you got a weapon data. Urgh, my eyes are flashing. By applying an Archie protocol to the nanomachines, you now have the ability to create the lock. The lock. The ability to form your debris into cubes. You can jump on them and use them as platforms. Ah. I see. And I can bring them back. Gotcha. So then, oop. Okay, that's kind of neat. Can I bring him back when I'm up here? Ah. Got ya, man. I'm feeling this. I'm feeling you again. You got me back. I was scared I wasn't gonna come back, but you got me. Well done. I mean, this definitely beats a double jump. Okay, it doesn't really, but it's a neat alternative. So thank you for that. You keep telling me this lock like I don't know what I'm doing, but I mean, I guess you are used to making a game meant for the younger audiences. What is that? Makes me want to put some square in the slot in the middle. I would say more of a diamond, but I understand. Oh, thank you. Gosh, crystal converters, a masterpiece made by your sweat and tears. Can convert certain quantity of debris into nanomachines. But it can only be used once before it is discarded. Please gain permission before using the device. Astra Venata, Viceroy of Samara. Samsara, I'm sorry. Huh. Okay. Fair enough. Come with me. Alright, so I've gotten two abilities. I've got an attack. I got this little block thing that goes with my momentum. I just realized that's kind of amazing. Okay, that's cool. Where's the boss? Come on. I know you got a boss waiting for me somewhere. There's no boss in here. There's little baby enemies. No boss. I'm missing a boss here. I'm not gonna say I'm upset, but I am. I need it. You know, it's a huge deal to me. These locks are quite heavy when you drop them. Never thought that nanomachines were powerful enough to lift up such heavy stuff. Maybe I can use some of the things. Wait, right. I did it. Okay, do it again. Okay, do it lightly. Good enough for me. No. Okay. All right. Try it again. I didn't need to do that, but you know, I needed to do that. Now, oh, that's the wrong one. There you go. I did it. Doc, are you watching? You better be, because your girl did good. I can do a lock there, and I can't go that way. Okay. I'll just plop it down right there. Easy peasy. another save point. Thank the Lord. Okay, moving on. What do you got for me now? I wanna go this way. Can you make it? Yep, you can.
Same thing?
Yep. Alright. Hold on. A little bit more. You gotta use the ability of pointing it further away because then it has more impact on the actual body of the structure. I learned that in life. That's a whole lot of broken shit. That was really easy. Give me a moment while I gather my resources. That is one large body of rock. Okay. If this isn't good enough for what I need to do, I don't know what is. I could go through there. Or I could go down here. Oh, I went back in the left. Fuck. Now I'm just gonna go and I'm not gonna mess up and it's not gonna crash and I don't gotta do things again that I did before. I'm gonna break this shit and I'm gonna move forward. I'm gonna be the robot cyborg girl that I know I can be. The one that I saw in my visions as a child. Come on, it's time to download. To be honest, I really don't like that feeling. Ah, the debris drill, of course. It looks like you got a weapon, Beta. The world is spinning. Oof. By applying an arc prototype to the nanomachines, you now have the ability to create the drill. The drill. The ability to form your debris into a drill that will pierce the heavens. Holy shit. Okay, I wasn't expecting that. I like the drill. The drill is a good thing. The drill is definitely one of my more favorite things I've ever found. Thanks, drill. Thanks for existing. Where other drills would not have, you did. And I think you're the best. I mean, I know a few things that might be a little stronger and cooler, but you're pretty cool in my book. Holy shit, Thrill. You even got like a back, like look at it. I shoot you and then like you come out the back. It's great. People put a lot of thought into this drill. And I appreciate them for it. Beautiful, man. If you mess that up, then I don't know what's wrong with you. You want this? Easy peasy. There you go. With the drill, you can get all your shit that you ever need in one easy quick fell swoop of a drill. It's the best. It's what one could say it's the bee's knees. However, bees are probably extinct in this world. Okay. Now then, with my newfound powers, I'm gonna break everything in half and then take all of their guts and use them to my advantage. Like that right there? Easy. Drills will dig through soft terrain, so you can grind straight across wide walls and blocks with a single shot of a drill. Okay, I see. So you're trying to tell me I should do this. Yep, that's cool. I like it. I'm gonna save. There you go. Let's go. Drill. Okay, get all your stuff back. This is neat. This is really cool. Oh, you want to do it again? It's satisfying. It has a good satisfying feeling when you do things. That's what the video games need. Satisfaction guaranteed. Also, that looks a little bonkers. I'm going to assume that will be fixed one of these days. Hopefully. Otherwise, it would just be a little weird. I'm gonna take this, and we're gonna open this door, and we're gonna finally, hopefully now, because we have three things. A boss fight? Can we get a boss fight? Is that a thing you could hook a brother up with, a sister up with? Hey there, girl. Are things going well with your blueprint collection? Why, yes, thanks to you. You're welcome. But, oh my god, they even put the wrong your. That's how early access this is. But, do you know what this means? Whoever granted you your new body to have such extensibility has got to be an outstanding genius. Here we go again. Well, to be honest, I want to thank you too. The more you fight and the more you use your arcs, the more I can collect valuable combat data. Next time I create a cyborg, I'm sure it'll be a much greater work of art. You're thinking of making another one? He's a weirdie, but a lovable one. That's a loud sound still, to this day. Okay. I run into things, and then I keep running into things. That's okay. No one was here to see it. It's fine. There, go on, download. I really wish this is the last time to do it. Debris Javelin. Ugh. Looks like you got a weapon, Data. Phew. I managed to bear it this time. By applying the ARC protocol to the nanomachines, now you have the ability to create the javelin. The ability to form your debris into javelins and shoot them out. They stick to the walls and you can use them as... Oh, okay, that's cool. That sounds cool. Wow. Okay. You got me. I can bring him back if I don't want him. And I can put him out again. You got me again. How do you do it? You do it, and then you do it again, and then I'm just in again. It's just a good sense of feeling all around. I left one behind. That'll be the one that tells my story. All right. Well, shit. That's a cool concept. Man, how many abilities are there? That's gotta be like the last one, right? That's a lot of abilities. I mean, one of them's down Y, another one's up Y. This has to be the final one. Like, there's no more. That's it. We've tapped the resources. Let's go over what we have. If the javelin is made of debris, it should weigh a bit. So if I shoot it into a loose object, it might be able to lose balance and make it fall over. Is that how this works? Oh. Okay, that's pretty cool. That is pretty cool stuff. I like it. And I can save. My world just keeps getting better. And then I want to hit it. Okay. I didn't even have to hit it. Can I hurt? I can totally hurt you, right? Yep. Okay. It's still a weapon. As it should be. However, it's no drill. Gosh. Be sure to pay special attention during pile driving at unstable heights. During pile driving? Okay. Oh, hold on. Oh wait. Okay. Well, I mean, sure. Sure thing, buddy. Oh. I'm losing some. But, you know what? I can't break it because the javelin takes over all my things. Little odd, but that's okay. It's fine. Don't tell anyone. Wait, I know what to do here. It's simple. There you go. Neat. It counts as an actual, like, object, so it holds it up like that instead of falling all the way over. Well played. Hello. My man. See, they put it right there to make you feel stupid if you don't get up there immediately. There's a save point down there. But do I really need it? Nah. Who needs save points? Official discipline. There have been reports of discrimination from combatant ajits against labor ajits. We should not act the same as those despicable humans. We ajits are each given separate occupations, but all occupations are equally honorable. Always remember that we are a single family. Astra Venata, Viceroy of Simasara. I've messed it up again. Wow. How'd I pull it off a second time? Who knows? Alright, sir. I could do this. It's been a minute. Yeah. Ah, I fucked it up. Do it again. Try it again. Do it. Yeah. Ah. Hey. Okay. Do it again. Holy shit. Okay, you know, I'm jumping over you. Ouch. Oh. I'm back. What up? It's your boy, me. How you doing? Wow, ah, come on, son. Yeah. Oh. Damn. You know what? I just remembered. All my vitality stuff's gone. I didn't hit the right button. That's okay. Do this thing. There you go. Okay, that's infinitely better. Now if I die and I gotta do that again, I'm gonna be sad. Let me hit you. Okay. See, your stuff goes all the way back there. I gotcha. I need to actually just keep hitting you, because I guess I still take some of your stuff off you. Hey there, girl. What? I think you've done well. To be honest, I want more data, but you got me enough. Now it's time for you to get out of there. Hey, Doc. Yeah? Those furnaces, they make all the robots, don't they? Those who killed my family and my friends. Those who ripped me up. Right. They're gonna kill more of our people, right? I assume. There'll be more lonely kids like me. Kids with no dreams or hope at all. But still couldn't choose to die. I suppose so. What's your point here? Oh? Doc, I'm gonna stay here. I'm gonna beat them up and destroy this place. But wait a minute. Weren't you telling me that you wanted to get out of here and... Yeah, I did, and I'm still scared. But now I have the power to defeat them. I don't want to run away from this place, just because I'm scared or don't like it. It's the same thing, say, to pretend not to see all those kids lose their family. That's just unfair. It shouldn't happen. You should know, even with your powers, it's not an easy job to accomplish. I know, but I have to do it. Well, well. For me, it's a chance to collect more real and fresh data. A so-called unmixed blessing to me. Okay, go ahead. But take care of yourself. I can do it, Doc. Let me prove it to you. Holy crap, there's a lot of them. Who cares? It's fine. Ouch. It's okay. You know what? I got a drill. Good deal. I can do this, Doc! You'll believe in me, but I do! I mean, you seem like you did believe in me, actually. Oddly enough. I say that and... It's fine. It's fine. Give me this stuff. Thanks. Appreciate the help. Alright. By the way, I got a gizmo which may help you on the way. The navigation map, an exploration assisting device. It roughly scans the terrain around you by sending weak electro waves to the nanomachines in the atmosphere. One may call it a nanomachine radar. I see. I got a really cool, or a really poor sense of direction, so this'll help. Me too. I couldn't find a decent rendering circuit, so ignore the slightly retro graphics. Yeah, man. I know. That's the wrong button. But this one right here, I'd actually like the retro graphics. You did good. This is cute. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you, Doc. You're a good Doc. I didn't know you were also a graphics designer. Okay. I know what to do here today. Okay, not that. Do this. There you go. I almost died. I gotta go back up. What happens if I go this way? I do this. Okay. So, now I just do this again. Actually, I could have just done this. Much better. See, with that, I don't have to do it three times. I could just do it once. And there's also the satisfying sound of knowing you're doing a lot of things with minimal effort. That's a good thing. Okay, dokie. Holy crap. Doc, what about this one? Doc? Doc? Hello? Jesus, Doc. Holy shit, Doc, it's got us. What the fuck, man? He was like, watch out for that one. But this thing is like suddenly a real threat. Bloodstill Arsenal Labor's slogan. Class Mangala has a round carapace. They bounce around and compress the surface. Class Mangala has a red body. Watch out or he'll crush everybody. Okay. Sure. Sure thing. You're doing some weird shit. I hope you realize this. Ah, that would have been sweet speed. I want to try it again. I want to do the speedrunner tactics here. Hold on. Not good enough. Good enough. Alright. Uh-oh. Hold on. Hey. Well, that was Omega Breaker or Giga Break Giga Wrecker. Giga Wrecker, that's the name. It's early access, so obviously it's a little borky, but I mean it ain't terrible. I think it's actually pretty good. I like the art, I like the concept, I like the idea and like the foundation. So they got a nice little, you know, skeleton for the game to be worked on, to put flesh onto it. So that's good. I guess I think this is a calling for me to be like, hey man, you can tap out now. You did your deeds. You did what you set out to do. So I'll just take it then. Alright, but that's it for me. If you guys like it, check out the game. It's a video game. Yeah, that's how I played it. It was a game with a video portion to it, but interactive and shit. It's pretty crazy. I'm gonna go though. So y'all have a good day, and I'll catch you another time. Later, guys.